Portrait 12. Waiting room door asks why I have waited for so long. I say I'm staying for a few bob. Door creaks and reinforced glass shimmers in humbling shrug. The painter is shading across four set portions of the studio, leaving slithering circles of sly, shy glances. Oh God, oh Jesus Christ. The bouncer isn't he going to let me in? Oh wait, his heat is on me. His eyes touch. Waiting room door. Studio door eeeeeeeeeesz. I'm in club art. Feet sheathed in trainers. Trainers off. My feet are not my pride, nor my joy. Why must he paint see every follicle? Flowers dash he grunts. Do you want me to hold? Also, how are you? Dash I only know you by phone number. Fine. Yes dash he shunts. Do you know how you wish them to be held? Dash I wish I knew you. It matters? Dash he munts. Left-handed as I am, my sheer leftness guffaws proudly and my port side's canonic levies bubble into instant, inefficient and automatic motion, and the bouquet will be reflecting in my left eye glass. No doubt. How does it make you feel? While my thoughts have distracted me from reality, the painter has laid birth to a small field of preserved grass and ignited a bulb behind me, careful to reminisce on a sunsetted scene. I practice my pose with minimal exertion. The painter delivers me a half-exterminated zoot and beckons me to relax. I feel the geezer humid cloud from his paws graze my own. He breathes like an obscured pathway. Don't move. Even slightly. I will see. How long is this going to dash? It has been 3 hours and my arm is no longer felt. The ash around is luck full. They, the ducks, have been given free passage. I sneezed once and was shown, with pansophic eyes, the direction of studio and waiting room door. I hadn't moved my eyes in a nice age, so it felt virginal. I know I will turn broody and psychotropic as soon as I am permitted to witness the crayon crackles that are supposed to ambassador my face. Clown 30 surely isn't worth losing an arm for. Emotion in the left has long gone now, from the crayon's suffocating glances between us and his waxen canvas. Left arm is drained of flux, about to stem leaf work and bend soil base. Shrapnel of duckling kisses is laid to rest on my shed skin, spasmodding me the cheeks and oozing forth an embarrassed scowl. My shirt. This is not the static of salty, stray material fondles my arms fields and tells me so. The crayon puppet seems to have placed us all in a rambunctious dream of beach haze, mobbed by duck spirits, catered for by his supreme pacificism. He is blinkless and should be prepared to be declined entry to his next bathe. My arm and me have gone long distance and he's rejoicing in my agony. Each stroke of the crayon I feel his double shanks grazing and petting my waistband.